audio plugins running on your video card. This isn't an entirely new concept. In the past there have been plugins with optimizations to also make use of the power of a graphics card. But GPU audio is taking the deep dive and developing tools and plugins to run on the processing power of a GPU alone. GPU audio claims they have solved some big issues that used to be with graphic card driven plugins, like communication between the CPU and GPU and using the plugins on multiple tracks. So that sounds really promising. There are two huge advantages with running plugins on your graphics card. The first is that it will offload your CPU, so you will have smoother performance in your DAW, because you will have more horsepower in total you can use. The second is that plugins will run in real time. This means you will be able to use what normally would be CPU hungry and latency introducing plugins when you monitor incoming audio. For instance, while recording or live performing. You're not wrong if this sounds like how Universal Audio runs their plugins. But the Universal Audio processing power is nowhere near the potential processing power of GPUs. There's a reason why Bitcoin farming runs on GPU, not CPU. It's because of its sheer processing power. Since this is a completely new architecture, plugins need to be rewritten to use the graphics card processor. To demonstrate the power of this GPU processing, GPU Audio has already released a free-to-download VST3 plugin. I consider this plugin to be more of a tech demo. It's a simple convolution reverb which uses impulse responses to create reverb. Now with the graphics card driven FurConvolver, I can load in 26 instances while also running OBS for the screen grab. If you look now at the GPU usage in Windows Task Manager, you'll see it uses about 92% GPU processing power. On a side note, big thanks to Chris for pointing me towards this plugin development. And after reading Chris's email, I wondered, did he subscribe? Did you subscribe? Just hit that button. Now keep in mind, just as your CPU while running plugins shares its processing power with other tasks, the same will apply while running plugins on your graphics card. So if you run basically any graphics, it will have its influence on how much and how well it will run. Ideally, you want to run the graphics card to just run plugins. And when you would build a new system, you could use that as a way to build your system around. But realistically, you'll be sharing your graphics card between running plugins and doing graphic tasks. A few scenarios I can think of is when you use a Windows laptop. They often come with two GPU drivers, which are onboard graphics and a Nvidia graphics GPU. You could let the plugins run on the Nvidia while the DAW uses the onboard graphics. Or when you have a beefy graphics card for video editing or gaming, you can use that power as well to offload your CPU. One thing you must do to make sure that the graphics card is performing best for plugins is to have your graphics driver prefer maximum performance at all times. This was a setting I needed to adjust to make sure I had smooth playback in Cubase 12. From what I gather, GPU Audio is very open to adjust and fine-tune what they will release based on what scenarios potential future users will use for these plugins, which is a good thing. In the longer run, they will open up the tech for third-party developers, which is also a good thing. Right now this development is for Nvidia graphics cards only, but AMD support will come soon. MacOS support is also planned for 2023 and even a DAW is in development. In May there will be a beta release of more plugins of what GPU Audio calls a meat and potatoes suite of plugins. And of course they will run on the GPU. That will be the first real test for this new tech. I will keep an eye on GPU Audio. What they do really is an exciting development for the audio world. All relevant links are in the description below.